When you flip rocks on the ocean floor at midnight, you can find all sorts of strange nocturnal sea creatures that you've probably never seen before.
That is an enormous worm. Look at the state of that thing. I'm putting this rock down. Ugh.
In this video, I'll be flipping 100 rocks to find all sorts of venomous worms, invisible crustaceans, and super rare creatures that even I've never seen before.
Oh, look what I've just found. Oh my word. Oh, that's so cool.
The mission begins at sunset, but I'll be staying underwater till midnight. And as the night goes on, the creatures that emerge get weirder and weirder. But spotting them at night can be pretty difficult. Unless, of course, you've got this secret weapon.
Now, we're also going to try these UV lights to find critters underneath these rocks and also see what they look like when they glow. For example, have a look at this guy. Whoa, look at those morays.
But the morays weren't the only critters packed tightly under the rocks.
We've got a big one here. Let's flip this one. Whoa! Look at all those brittle stars. There's hundreds of them.
These brittle stars often hide in clumps under rocks, emerging at night to scavenge on detritus, plankton, and food scraps. Now, there are hundreds of different species, from delicate forms to big spiny giants, but they all have one thing in common.
I've got to be very careful with them because, as their name suggests, they're pretty brittle.
But this raises an important point.
So the rocks we're going to be flipping up really close to the beach. And that's because the waves and the swell here creates these lovely natural cavities for creatures to hide in. But it's really important to mention that when we're flipping rocks in the ocean, there's a chance we're going to disturb marine life. So we need to set some ground rules.
Only loose rocks will be flipped. All rocks will be placed back down exactly where we found them. And if we can see something hiding under, in, or on a rock without flipping it, it'll remain unflipped. Like the critter hiding alongside Rock 9. Cowries are shelled mollusks, but at night they go through a remarkable transformation, extending their fleshy mantles over their shells to protect them from erosion and improve their overall camouflage.
And now you can see the fleshy tissue of this cowrie is completely covered in shell. And this is what they look like during the night. So this one will be off to hunt shortly.
Like the other smaller species of cowries that emerge from under Rock 14 to feed. However, whilst no rocks in the ocean are lifeless, many are just covered in sessile animals like sponges and corals, as well as algae and cyanobacteria. So from now on, I'll just show you the rocks hiding the really special critters, like Rock number 19.
Right, we're going for a big one. Whoa! Look at this sea cucumber! These things are crazy! What on earth are these?
Some species of sea cucumber spend their days wedged under rocks, emerging at night to feed. Using a ring of feathery tentacles around their mouths, they sift through the sand and detritus, digesting organic matter and recycling nutrients that keeps the reef healthy. However, sea cucumbers are also a favoured ride for all sorts of different reef hitchhikers.
Oh, look at this thing!
This is a bumblebee shrimp, a tiny crustacean that can often be found running along the bodies of sea cucumbers and other echinoderms, picking off parasites and feeding on leftover detritus. This relationship is symbiotic, with both the shrimp and the sea cucumber benefiting. However, other hitchhikers are much less welcome, like this critter, that is possibly a species of parasitic worm or leech. But whilst the critters hiding under Rock 19 didn't pose much of a threat, to me at least, this is the ocean, and there is danger everywhere.
Oh my word! That was close, I nearly got stabbed then.
And these stingrays aren't the only creatures armed with venomous spines.
Right, let's see what is under this rock. Oh, no way! Look at this fireworm! Oh, that thing is scary! These are incredibly venomous, so you definitely do not want to get stung by one of these bristles.
And like a lot of creatures, they make it well known they're not to be messed with by displaying bright, vibrant colours. Whilst this one is green, others opt for more obvious danger-signalling tones, like the one we found under Rock 42.
Oh, look at the size of this thing! These fireworms are polychaete worms, which basically means they're segmented. Now, these fireworms are nocturnal hunters, so at some point tonight, this guy will come out and rootle around on the sand looking for things to eat. But yeah, that is some Pretty nightmarish stuff, that is.
However, whilst so far most of the things I'd found were pretty easy to spot, many creatures are highly evolved to be almost invisible to the naked eye. And as the night got darker, it became harder and harder to find things. Unless, of course, they move.
Oh, well, that's a cool little decorator crab just here. Look at this guy. Where's he gone? There he is. And these decorator crabs are so named because they obviously decorate themselves with... Oh, sorry, mate. Hang on. Oh, where's he gone? Here he is. No, you can go back on your rock. Oh, he's just holding on to this little pebble now, unfortunately, but I'm sure he'll make his way back here soon.
As their name suggests, decorator crabs decorate themselves with algae, debris, and anything else they can find to help them blend into their environment. And some of them are much better at it than others.
That's gotta be the craziest looking one I've ever seen. You cannot tell me that that thing is alive. It's just a ball of floating algae. You watch him disappear, look, as he goes back down on the reef. There you go. Invisible. Gone.
However, whilst under visible light, these decorator crabs are pretty difficult to spot. Almost all crustaceans have a weakness that was perfectly displayed by the enormous critter hiding under Rock 57.
Whoa! Look at the size of that guy! This is an enormous swimming crab. You can tell that because he's got paddle or flipper-like appendages at the back, on his back legs. This guy's just hunkered down for the night, hoping to stay undetected.
Although under UV light, I'm not sure he stands much of a chance. This awesome colour transformation is known as fluorescence. When UV light hits the crab's shell, it excites electrons that then release energy in the form of visible light. Under UV, all crustaceans glow green and blue, although some are great at hiding it, like the crab that was running around on Rock 59.
You can see how it's the red algae that fluoresces, the same as this stuff here, or the stuff on the rocks. I think the crab itself is fluorescing a slightly green or yellow colour, but otherwise you would never see that look. He's perfectly camouflaged against the bottom. And there's my fingernails. Look at them glow.
However, it's not just the crabs and shrimps that glow.
I'm spoiled for choice. There's rocks everywhere. Oh, well, this here isn't a rock, although it's coming out of a rocky tube, but these anemones here fluoresce insanely well under UV light.
The majority of corals also glow vibrant greens and blues. Many shallow water corals do this to protect themselves from the sun's harmful UV rays, as well as to help the symbiotic algae that lives in their tissues photosynthesize more effectively. Some fish species also fluoresce, like the predator I found under Rock 61.
Right, let's flip this rock. Oh, look at this wasp fish!
A lot of this wasp fish's vibrant fluorescence comes from the various different pieces of organic matter that it's stuck to its body. A little bit like the rough-snout ghost pipefish that were glowing the same colour as the algae and cyanobacteria covering the rocks. But for some groups of fishes, fluorescence is much more prominent, although it doesn't always come as standard. Some moray eels, for example, don't glow at all, but others are incredibly easy to pick out with UV as they traverse the sand.
Wow, look at him glow! This moray is usually tucked under rocks, but today he's out.
Moray eels are a common find under rocks on the ocean floor at night, but they come in all sorts of shapes, colours and sizes.
Oh, there's loads of morays under this rock. Look at these guys.
Rock number 66 was home to a small gathering of white-eyed morays, a species that typically hunt more during the day. But not all moray species are so social.
Whoa! Look at this little eel!
Whilst morays can easily squeeze into the tight cracks and crevices on the ocean floor, many other fish that hide during the night aren't really the right shape, and instead just hunker down, trying to blend in.
I need some more rocks to flip. Don't worry, Mr. Puffer, I won't flip your rock.
Others are the right shape, but seemed much more interested in harassing me than hiding or hunting.
Yep, hello, Mr. Cornetfish. What do you want? I'm trying to flip rocks. Give me a second. Hang on, I'm not trying to film you.
However, the rocks do provide safe haven for many smaller reef species, like chromis, damsels, and juvenile butterfly fishes.
What do we got under here? Oh, well, there's a little butterfly fish just here. This is a little black-lipped butterfly fish.
In fact, many juvenile fishes hunker down under the rocks at night. Even the predators, like these juvenile blue-striped snappers. And every hole and crevice gets used. As we neared midnight, the crepuscular creatures that hunt at dusk disappeared back into the reef, making way for the really strange nocturnal creatures, like the critter we found under rock number 74.
So we'll look under this one. Oh, look at this thing!
This is a fragile file shell, a bivalve related to scallops and clams. Now, unlike most bivalves that stay put, these file shells can actually swim by clapping their shells together and jetting out water. As their name suggests, their shells are incredibly fragile, and they spend a lot of time partially hidden under rocks, or anchored in and amongst debris with their tentacle-like mantle tissue extended out. However, other critters apply very different strategies to avoid predators on the reef at night.
Nothing much there, just a big encrusting sponge and a little crab. Oh, actually, this is interesting just here. So this thing here is called a chitin. And these are actually one of the oldest species of mollusk on the planet. They're about 400 million years old. And these guys have these eight plates that overlap. And they do a very good job of clinging to surfaces like this, so that predators can't pull them off.
But these chitins are bland, grey, and spend most of their time just clinging to hard surfaces. Other mollusks, however, like the one we found under Rock 81, have developed very different strategies for staying alive.
Oh, look at this thing! Oh, yes! Wow, look at that! What a fantastic little nudibranch that is, look! You can see that the rhinophores on its head, the little sensory organs that it uses for detecting food and other things. And then on the back, you can see the serrata that it uses for respiration.
Like many creatures in the ocean, this nudibranch's bright colours are also aposematic, advertising toxicity to predators.
That is an awesome nudibranch. I've never seen one like this before. Let's pop him back down on the reef and let him go about his way.
By this point, it was after midnight, and every rock I flipped revealed something new. But hiding under rock number 94 was something that didn't look like anything else I'd ever seen before.
Oh, look what I've just found. Oh my word, look at him. Oh, that's so cool. Look at this fantastic algae octopus. This is the first one I've ever seen.
Algae octopus are so named because of their ability to blend in perfectly with the algae-covered rocks on the ocean floor. They also have another neat trick, the ability to walk along the bottom using their eight hairy tentacles. Until, of course, they decide to do what octopus do best, disappear. If you're new here, make sure to hit that subscribe button. And if you're in the mood for more ocean adventures, you'll probably like this video.